Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how to do some WebSocket programming with Node.js. We'll go through some examples together in JavaScript. We're going to create always-on socket connections between a client and a server, and also between a client and a client. This can be used to bidirectionally send data to the peer process over the internet at any instant. This comes in handy when you're building a chat application or a multiplayer online game, or a stock ticker app, real-time GPS location tracking on a map, a real-time web auction, or anything in between. Let's get started with some vanilla Node.js code for client-server communication. Here we have some server code. In production, you would deploy this application using a web hosting provider like AWS, and clients would connect to it using their internet connection. The Node.js native net library enables us to easily open and handle a socket connection. The server starts up and binds to port 9898. Before starting up, we assign an event handler to execute when a client connects to the server. After a client connects to this app over a TCP connection, the server sends a string to the client which says, "Hello, this is server speaking." The server will log any data that the client sends to the server. Just before the socket connection closes, the server tells the client, "Closing connection now." Next, we'll see some client Node.js code followed by some browser JavaScript that would connect through a conventional web page. A client app would use the same net library in Node.js. We create a connection to a server, which is at localhost port 9898. When the TCP socket connection is established, the client sends a string to the server saying, "Hello, this is client." When the server sends data to the client logs it here. Let's see this client-server interaction run live. You can see that the client initializes a connection with the server, they exchange some strings, and then the client disconnects and terminates. Before I show you what we do in a web browser to connect to the server using WebSockets, how would one connect two clients for bidirectional messaging? This is a bit complicated. You'd have to do some sort of routing in your server app to turn it into a broker for the two clients. You can't directly connect two clients because they don't always have publicly accessible IP addresses. Your server app always will, so the server component is necessary if you want to implement peer-to-peer bidirectional messaging. Let's see what JavaScript looks like in the browser for WebSocket connections. Socket programming in the browser is a bit complicated, but WebSocket programming is not. And it achieves the same goal for us. I'm going to switch my socket server code to WebSocket server code. In the browser, we can natively use the WebSocket protocol with the built-in objects which work in all modern browsers. I'll run my WebSocket server script in the terminal and load my HTML file in Google Chrome. You can see that the browser connects to the server, they each send a string to one another, and then the connection ends. If I refresh the web page in my browser, you see the same thing again. Awesome! But what about client-to-client communication? This can be achieved for browser-to-browser, Node.js client-to-Node.js client, browser-to-Node.js client, and everything in between. You can do this easily using a service like PubNub. If your device can speak TCP, it can do bidirectional device-to-device communication at any message volume. PubNub is free to sign up, and your free API keys can be used to send up to a million messages per month forever. This makes PubNub an easy choice for hobbyists, students, and businesses trying to build a proof of concept. Let's see what the client-to-client message transfer code looks like with Node.js. By the way, this code is almost identical for the web browser JavaScript. Here we have client 1. First, we connect to the globally distributed, infinitely scalable PubNub network using our free API keys. Next, we subscribe to a channel. Channels are created when you use them. You can make as many as you want, and they live forever. Subscribing means your device is listening for any messages that are published on the specific channel. Remember that you can subscribe to one or many channels at a time. Here we add an event handler that executes when a new message is delivered through the subscription. Next, we set up a function that executes whenever the user presses their return key. The PubNub publish method sends a message on a channel using the PubNub network. Remember, this message can be a string, number, JSON object, whatever you want. I also made another script that's pretty much identical, except it publishes a message that indicates that it is client number 2. I'm going to run the two PubNub-based scripts in two terminal windows to show the instant, peer-to-peer, bidirectional message passing capability of PubNub. Whenever I hit the Enter key on a focus terminal window, the script sends a new PubNub message. Both scripts are listening on the same channel, so they will see the same data on both sides. This would work the same way if the other script was running on a machine on the other side of the world. The latency of PubNub messages in transit is generally under 250 milliseconds, depending on the client's distance from one another. PubNub enables this awesome PubSub messaging functionality for building chat apps, multiplayer games, live geolocation tracking on maps, and so much more. About 43 billion messages are sent over the PubNub network every single day, and we have more than 2,000 happy customers. Try out PubNub for free at dashboard.pubnub.com/signup. Also check out our GitHub for starter code in every programming language so you can get started building your next application really fast. Thanks for watching.